Andy, mate, your mogs are looking fucking shit, dude. We need to update this, otherwise we won't be able to do any more competitions or out. Andy!
Let me tell you a little story, dickhole.
Hello, and welcome to the Freeze Gaming Arena. Tonight we have a special main event. Mr. Mike Preachwell will be taking on Team Panda. I am Vanish.
And I am Orgus. I've just been backstage and I've just seen Preach's small cock.
Well, we all know about that. Nobody's surprised there.
Remember the mop launch, right? BlizzCon 2011, the Mets up on stage getting the crowd as hyped as possible, and then... oh, fuck. Did you know that the mop reveal trailer is the most disliked Blizz video? Yeah. It's now flooded with, lol, everyone who thought mop was gonna be the shit, don't you look stupid. But that wasn't because of the Monkey Monks, oh now. It was those damn pandas. The news of the monk class joining WoW was possibly the most underwhelming reaction I've ever seen in WoW since the addition of a transmog forum. The shitstorm about pandas is a conversation for the mop legacy, but needless to say, the poor monks were drowned out in the noise. I think for most of the player base, it was simply impossible to separate the monk from the panda, and frankly, most didn't think pandas were cool.
I've managed to pinpoint the exact moment where the monk became null and void to everybody. So we had this cool intro, and then it went into all this stuff, which nobody really knew about, right? And people are asking, why is all this like Chinese themed and all that? And they're all getting a bit confused. And where it was like the DK, it was like super hype. Now people are starting to get a little bit worried because we've got things like bouncing bunnies. What the fuck, right? And then here it is. This is the point where everybody who had a pair of nuts instantly did this. Now that's your problem. Because what they then said was, oh, we get a Pandaren, facepalm, right? Then they immediately said the monk, but nobody saw it. Because of the facepalm, that's what it was. Yeah, that's what it was.
They had also changed some things. See, the DK was called a hero class, and the monk wasn't.
So as you can see, using science, putting hero in front of it means it's better.
More realistic was that the monk was to start at level 1 as opposed to the instant 55 you got with the DK. Even with the obscene leveling speed we now know monks came with thanks to their daily buff plus heirloom items convincing the average WoW player that it was going to be just fine. No. Although a massive buzzkill on top of all that was the slow-ass way spells and talents were given out. Once again compared to the DK who got showered in spells from the get-go. it made sense since the monks came packaged with the pandas, which had their own starting story, but it certainly lessened interest. When it came to the Mists of Pandaria beta, all over the forums were people pointing out their disinterest in trying out this shiny new class, in favour of just continuing their mains. A complete twist on the relation to the DK just a couple of years earlier, where everyone who was a proven edgelord, chomping at the bit to infest their targets with diseases. You might think I'm exaggerating to entertain you. You might think, oh, come on, Preacher, it's not that bad. But check this. The monk is consistently the least played class in the game since its inception. Mists of Pandaria, Walls of Draenor, Legion. Even with a 4-year head start, more people have capped a demon hunter in Legion than monks, and nearly as many are playing one as a main class. And what a crying shame. The monk is an amazing piece of design. It's consistently represented by people such as myself as one of the best overall classes you can play. Let's go back to the beginning and try and see what's up. Can it be, after all this time, that it's just that it's linked to pandas? Or is the monk just shit? Each monk spec was utterly unique and wonderful in its own way. Combinations of bits and pieces of other existing classes, but put together in an entirely new way. Let's start with the Brewmaster, bolstering the tanking ranks to gain even greater queue times in the LFD. The Brewmaster was the first to make use of the tanking style, which wouldn't actually become widespread until Walls of Draenor, as opposed to the more reactive style of the DKs. The Brewmaster carried the tools for godlike active mitigation, but barely anyone understood what that was, especially after a near decade of having the whole thing be very simple. Tanks have more armor, more block, more HP, and simply take less damage. Take damage, heal it. Now we had a tank that was constantly draining HP, which your day-to-day healer thought was utterly retarded. Not to mention that Brewmasters were shrugging off huge hits that could kill other tanks. It was during an LFR run for a guide in the Heart of Fear that my eyes really opened to what people thought of Brewmasters. I was scolded hard by a priest for being a paper tank on Windlord Mal'jarak. Once he opened his mouth, the torrents of Brewmaster hate flooded in from the rest of the raid. Once I pointed out that said priest hadn't actually bothered to dispel a single of the damage-increasing buffs on the many, many ads that were pummeling my face, they didn't care. The torrent continued. So despite the Brewmaster having very interesting gameplay, they were ostracized for their new and strange ways. I could honestly only find a couple of Brewmasters in use by the time of Will of the Emperor. It wasn't until the Throne of Thunder that the potential for Brewmasters started to shine, as the top guilds started to incorporate them. Method used on their Lei Shen world first. Brewmasters had this ludicrous ability to interact with their statue and put guard on the entire raid via their damage. With the tanking mechanic Vengeance being so obscene at that point, Brewmaster became not only one of the top DPS in the final and most difficult part of the fight, but put out as much healing as suddenly as if you'd ported in an extra healer during the most hard part. People were starting to take notice that the cheeky shruggers were capable of some very cheesy goodness, a theme that would continue throughout their lifetime. The problem was, they weren't exactly overpowered. Other tanks, particularly the paladins, were just better. More damage, more cooldowns, and it's hard to fight that battle, especially if it's been the case since the beginning of the expansion. We're now going to see something, which seriously holds back the addition of new classes to the game. Whenever a new class is added, that means people have to abandon what they already have. If that class isn't overpowered or super cool, then it's a much more difficult sell to the customer. Even more so if the class they already have capped, not level 1, has a multitude of achievements, individual memories and mementos, etc., and of course is actually doing better than the brand new class, then why the fuck would you re-roll? If someone was trying to sell you a TV with the exact same TV, if not worse, you wouldn't buy it. It makes no sense. You kind of see the bigger picture now as to why the monk was basically on the back foot from the beginning. You might remember that DKs launched in an extremely broken state, doing immense DPS in comparison to other classes, and the tank specs having more cooldowns than anyone else. Not something your average edgelord is going to miss. Let's be honest here. Most people just aren't that interested in gameplay. When it comes to choosing a class, a gameplay might even take months to really understand. What they really want to know is, does it do mad deeps and does it look sick AF? The Mistweavers brought their own amazing skills, as did the Brews. Blizzard was finally trying to get a proper DPS healing setup done. Mistweavers launched with a variety of stances, similar to classic warriors, as did the other monk specs. But instead of a rather rudimentary smart heal system like the Discipline Priests have been hodgepodging together for the past few years, Mistweavers actually had a very fluid melee DPS rotation, which didn't deny the use of healing spells already in play, giving it a very dynamic feel that apparently many healers have been asking for since the idea of a DPS healing hybrid came up back in vanilla. It has to be said, the Mistweaver was generally the most popular spec of the monks. As a big surprise then, you might find that it was the most powerful healer at launch.
Isn't it weird how those things seem to just come together?
Before we get into the broken bit though, the Mistweaver in itself was a pure exercise in creativity. Blizzard had been trying to fix healers since Wrath of the Lich King, which was the major turning point of all healers, having seemingly infinite mana and being able to spam non-stop from the beginning to the end of encounters. In Kata, they attempted to homogenize healers in the most horrendously dull way by giving them slow, efficient heals and fast, expensive heals as a basic toolset, then throwing on some flavor spells afterwards. It didn't work, and midway through the expansion, healers were back to spamming non-stop. Hell, I even had to make guides telling people to just use their shit on cooldown. With the Mistweaver, they did what Blizzard does best. But sadly, sometimes they need a kick up the ass to actually do it. They threw the traditional book out of the window. Why care about mana? Why are we working so goddamn hard to make healers care about mana when ultimately has to make it easier? When you think about it, gear has to at least make spells more powerful, which ultimately will lead to less healing needed. So they have to go up with the damage output, which means healers need to heal more, no doubt faster, as haste levels always increase. And frankly, you just can't control the healing classes so much that they go out of mana, or the encounters simply won't be doable. And no way in hell do we want to go back to vanilla strats of having people AFK constantly in the fight so they can regenerate mana by, you know, just not casting. Instead, let's just assume healers always have mana. With that being done, we can make the way they heal become way more interesting instead. And so to rapturous applause from the creativity gods, the Mistweaver was brought into existence. I can already imagine the nostalgia of several mop Mistweavers when they think about cheat torpedoing through the entire raid team and it actually being an effective technique. Traditionally, healers hated having to heal and move, but fuck tradition, we're now riding the choo-choo train. Not only that, but having HOTS that sort out people furthest away from the target instead of people who were right next to the target was a revelation. Unfortunately though, the dream wasn't to last too long. The Mistweavers were very, very powerful early on. Powerful enough for raids to be bringing two of them in a lot of occasions. Bolstered when Revival, which you probably know as the uber mega heal, only healed 6 people originally and eventually was moved to 15. A change that meant it had to be nerfed very quickly the next patch. Combine that with the supremely powerful ability to not run out of mana and spam AoE heal a huge amount of the raid, especially in the 10 man arena, the nerfs came. These nerfs were justified. It brought them into balance with the rest of the classical healers, but as we know, balance isn't what people want when it comes to trying out new classes. On to the Windwalkers then. I left this till last as I feel it was hit the hardest by the lack of attention the monks got. Now, as with everything we've covered so far, it's not as if monks were ignored, and all three specs popped up in near enough every raid environment. The main point is that there was no hype train. Beyond the panda line of thinking, a part of me put it down to the monk class not being cool. And by cool, I mean emo. Again, comparing it to the DK. When I initially read the list of Windwalker abilities, I thought it sounded totally cool. Touch of Death sounded way overpowered. Flying Serpent Kick, which was a superhero landing, and Fists of Fury carried animations to make your granny quiver. But I was seemingly left in the minority on this. The reaction across the player base was that everything about it sounded stupid and childish. So I guess it's time to bring back in Kung Fu Panda. Honestly, I don't blame anyone who only saw Jack Black as a bumbling buffoonish Kung Fu master every time they looked at gameplay of the Windwalker Monk. Many probably still do. These abilities weren't cool, they were cartoonish. But even more than that, the Windwalker wasn't the easiest thing to play. It wasn't that long ago, but I bet many forget about having to stack Tiger Palm up 3 times to use the buff. Storm Earth and Fire didn't show up till 5.2, that's the Throne of Thunder, and as we all know, was apparently very difficult to use. mixing, Zuwen taunting everything just annoyed others, including the brewmasters who used it, and seemingly pointless spells like Path of Blossoms. The ability to drop deadly flowers in various areas just lingered oddly in the spellbook. Again, I'm not saying Windwalkers didn't have a place in raids, they absolutely did, but the combination of having more to do than others, bigger chances of failing compared to others, and not dominating, isn't the most inspirational reason to reroll. Hell no. So WoD came around and made sweeping changes to the game as a whole, and this shiny new underplayed class was gonna take a hit, even in its infancy. Mistweaver was the big one on the chopping block. The overall implementation of the base healing standards culled some of the unique playstyle that made the Mistweaver so attractive. On top of that, it seems as though the loudest anti-Mistweaver voices in MOP was that it didn't feel like the classic healers. Now, this isn't the first time we've seen this. The introduction of Tree Farm for the Resto Druids was universally met with disdain. The idea of just being able to cast Hots and being unable to cast Healing Touch, lol, made so little sense to users that it was shit on from a great height. That time though, Blizzard stuck to their guns, and I imagine there are very few players now who can imagine the Resto Druid playing any other way. This time though, Blizzard tried to alter the Mistweaver into something more akin to the other healers. Cast times were added to the previously instant cast spells, altering that flowing gameplay. A new breed of player also popped up. Team Fistweaver. Team Fistweaver was very, very into the idea of being able to DPS heal, and I don't blame them. Stances were still around in Worlds of Draenor, and they should have been viable.
And that sadly meant that it was no longer viable, which is... Don't shoot me, it's not my fault it was no longer viable.
Don't tell me what's fucking viable, mate! Yeah? Get under your desk! Triggering someone! Idiots!
The focus was clearly on bringing the Mistweaver into the mainstream, not necessarily to increase adoption rates, as having a Mistweaver wasn't a rarity, but simply to meet overall healing direction. Fistweaving wasn't going to cut it outside of singular occasions, which many people cling to as an example of it being overall viable, clinging to that hope like when that girl replied to your text that one time, ensuring marriage. WoD though, mate. WoD was the time of the brewmaster to shine. This was the era of Guard. Oh, Guard. Never forget.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again.
So, yeah. Guard was all the cheese and pretty much the only thing people cared about, but that's never enough cheese for the brewmaster. The real cheese was at Blackhand solo tanking siege engines, jumping off cliff edges to bypass entire mechanics, and let's not forget being able to soak an entire train ramming up your ass. Although the major cheese is what the brewmaster is going to be remembered for in WoD, the brewmaster's mobility played so well in nearly all encounters from BRF onwards and dominated the challenge mode tank scene. Yet still, with all this going on, the monk once again flounders as the lowest played class in the game. The Windwalker was in a similar spot, doing extremely well damage-wise with many encounters that played to their strengths. At this point in the monk legacy, it's utterly confirmed to me that gameplay and power aren't a factor when it comes to the monk's seemingly disastrous addition to the game. I think disaster is the appropriate word here, and not just something to generate reactions. The other two examples of new classes joining the game have both been leaps and bounds more successful than the monk. The Demon Hunter spits in the face of the idea that historic attachment to a class is a factor in the decision to reroll for many. You might also be thinking, well, what about PvP? But unfortunately, the results are the same.
Thank you.
moving into Legion, and once again the real enemy of the monk shines as bright as the day they were originally announced. Community perception. Even in the early days of Legion, when we were all seeing via logs and simply from our guildmates that at least the Mistweavers and Windwalkers were doing extremely well, there it was. The one boss that wipes the monk every day. Community perception. Regularly, we were seeing fresh posts about how bad these specs are, and that only a complete retard would play them, and Windwalkers are some of the worst, don't take them to anything, whereas most of us would actually give our left nut to bring one to a Mythic Plus. Usually some out-of-context log post of a randomly selected percentile was enough to set people off. The legacy of the monk is one of great sadness to me, and one I hope I've drawn attention to. Ultimately, my conclusion is that the monk just isn't cool. It's not instantly appealing, it has no fireworks, its launch was the number one chance for it to draw people in, but its launch was a complete mockery of memes and jibes. The association of pandas made it such an easy target that it was uncool to many to actually support or even show interest. We have the proof of widespread not giving a shit about it whatsoever. As time moved on and new players joined the game, put yourself in their shoes when picking a new class. Look at the initial visuals that they give when picking a new character. Arguably, the monk is the absolute worst. It's literally a belt. The hunter is also pretty terrible, but then select a DK, a warrior, or God forbid a demon hunter, and it's not even in the same league to draw people in. Why do I care then? For me, the monk is one of the most interesting and fun specs in the game. It has consistently provided mold-changing options to the game. Coming into Legion, I rated all three of the specs as some of the best in the game, yet it will go on being the most underplayed, probably, for all time, unless they're giving something outrageously cool and over the top. I encourage everyone to give the monk a go at some point.
My final conclusion here is that I think Blizzard let the monk down with a simple misstep in marketing, and it takes years to change the community's minds on things. The legacy of the monk is pretty simple. First impressions are everything.
Way too long.